Oh, arrows, no, stop. Hey. All right, there's a whole courtyard of people down here, and I'd like to take care of those people, but, you know, let's maybe take care of Archer Dude in the tower first. That seems like a worthy priority, because then he won't be shooting me the entire time I fight everybody else. It's enough that they've all got dogs now, although I will say that these big heavy guys started off more intimidating at first, but got less intimidating as I dealt with the two of them at once with the two dogs. I assume those are the same guys. I think these guys will wake up. Can I go quietly? That guy looks dead. Yeah. Soul of a weary warrior. That guy might not be dead, though. Let's prioritize the archer over anything else. Especially if he hasn't seen me yet. Hello, tower. Yeah, this definitely feels like Painted World. I mean, we're already in Painted World. That's explicit, but I mean, this reminds me of something specific about it. Whoa! That was a bit of a surprise. Is everyone downstairs awake all of a sudden? No? They might not wake up. I just didn't really want to test it yet, but I guess we're about to test that. Hi, sir. Oop. Ah, that has so much less range than I expect it to every time. Especially with a given, like, how much movement they have. Whew. I'm getting better at fighting you. Gotcha. Alright, once we got down, it was way easier. So I guess these are both dead. Yep. Thought they were sleeping, but then everything went wrong, and the game did not punish me for it, because they were actually just corpses the entire time. Don't trust any of them, though. Thank God this isn't Dark Souls 2, so my durability is not that much of a problem, so I can just kind of melee them all like a jackass and hope things work out. Okay. Staircase and ladder. I don't trust ladder. Oh, wait, can I make that? That might not be possible. That seems like a wall is blocking me. And we can't look straight up to see if it's a trap or not. Let's find out. Let's find out. Oh, I hear a lizard. Somewhere. There he is. He hasn't run away yet. That's a good sign. For me? Hello. You must be the main archer. Yep. Oh, he's glowy-eyed. That's concerning. Off the cliff with you. Is that really gonna work out? Oh, not really, huh? Maybe he'll walk off. There he goes. He's not dead, though. Well, archer problem removed for the moment, until I die and he respawns, unless red eye means that he's not gonna respawn. Should I keep going up? Let's go up first. That's got a dead end soon. Any traps up here? I almost expect them to throw a boulder down, like they did in previous games. And we've already established the idea of collapsing platforms in this one. Do I drop down on you, or can I jump to you? That is a hell of a risk-reward jump, huh? Let's just go up. I can probably drop down from slightly above for minimal fall damage punishment instead of what's going to inevitably happen when I try to platform. Because have I died 100 times to fall damage yet in Dark Souls? I probably have. I probably died 100 times across the 5 games just for trying to make jumps. There's a soul up here. Is that going to collapse? It's the thing at the very top. What is it? Captain's Ashes. Oh, hey. New ashes for the lady. I've dealt with the archer problem, so I don't want... if I didn't have stuff to redo, I would... Sunflower Samurai. Alright, let's just go ahead and get healed in advance. Alright, we're not gonna look at those ashes right now. I have to deal with the fact that an invader has showed up. Let's see. And they could be anywhere, couldn't they? Alright. They really could be anywhere. And of course the question always is, are they going to try to use the environment against me or just fight me normally? What's over here? Millwood battle axe. Alright, we'll get to the battle axe and the ashes in a bit. I need to make sure I'm not going to get murdered today. Ah. It's always rough when you don't know where the invader is. I don't even know the level very well. I don't know how big the zone is he might spawn in or something like that. He has to come up this ladder, though, if he's not already here. Huh. You know what? I feel like being cheeky. Now if he comes up, he has to fight that guy that's at the bottom of the stairs. So I'll know he's coming. He might even have very abruptly gotten a surprise just now. Hello. Ethereal Oak's shield. So we have three items to check out now. Aha! Oh right, I'm in the way of the blue. I forgot about that. That was mainly because I was leveling up and I didn't want people fucking with me while I was trying to level. Hey red guy. Now there's a defensive guy here. What the hell? I have two blue sentinels. I guess I'll just casually look at my items now. Alright. It's a key item. Umbral Ash of the Captain of the Millwood Knights. With this, the Shrine Maiden will prepare new items. Long ago, when the Millwood Knights lost the forest they call home, they began a journey so long that even the thoughts of their sworn enemy washed away, replaced by a vision of a cold and brittle wood. Alright. He hasn't shown up. He has to go up that ladder, I think, which is guarded by NPC, and I apparently have two blue sentinels on my team right now, so the chance of being in trouble here is surprisingly low. Millwood Battleaxe. Battleaxe wielded by Millwood Knights. Its blade is blessed by the symbol of Ethereal Oak. Its hefty axe normally wielded by the mightiest warriors. It's got Warcry. And there's a Millwood Ethereal Oak Shield. Char Bronze Shield used by Millwood Knights that slowly regenerates hit points. Shield appears to be blessed by a great, if faded, image of Ethereal Oak. Interesting. Equipping the shield in the left hand allows one to perform skill in the right hand. So it's a weapon skill item. It heals you over time. 100% block. Not super psyched about how high it'll pump my defense, though. I mean, my equip load. Oh, wait, no, never mind. It's actually lighter than my current one. Alright. I'll equip a new shield that gives me health recovery and looks good with my current equipment. Someone's giving me experience right now. Look, a light shite nice shard. Somebody found a... Oh, he healed. Don't do that. Stop healing. Oh, God. It'd be a bad time to have that, missing person show up, huh? Alright. Hey, buddy. Oh, no. Mixed results. Alright, so I have two blue sentinels and an invader all in my game at the same time. They could be literally anywhere, but hey, they're all killing something right now, because I'm getting experience. This guy might be tough. I'm stuck. Ow. Well, this is where I fought the other guy, so at least there's that. Ow! Okay, this is a confined area for this. Just gotta be cautious. I fought the other guy, alright. Just need to do that again. It's a little... Ooh! Ooh! I thought he wasn't gonna hit me because there was like a wall in the way. Hello. Just be careful. Woohoo! If that invader shows up right now, I'm so screwed. Oh shit. I fell. Had to do a double take just to make sure I'm not under attack. This is so much like the frigid outskirts where you'd get attacked by people and you'd like... I don't know, there's an invader and a blue sentinel somewhere in my game. They could be anywhere. I hope they're having fun. They're all presumably here because of me, but I literally know where none of them are. But they keep He attacks kind of around things on a regular basis. Are you healing over time? It would make sense because you have the shield we established does that. Uh-oh. Woohoo! Uh-oh. Oh, look who! What a piece of shit! Oh, you bastard. Yep. Wow, he's not very durable, is he? Oh, there goes one of my summons. He's getting attacked from behind. Hello, Seven Flower Samurai. Oh, there's a wolfman. This is a bizarre PvP encounter. I'm kind of happy it's happening, though. It's amusing to me. Oh, that wolf likes me. Fixed it. I'm so happy the sea of the giants exists. Some people get mad at me for how I treat invaders sometimes, but they're invaders. No sympathy. It's such a bummer when you get the shockwave of the impact on somebody. I mean, the blood splatter, but it doesn't actually hit them. And the blood splatter's wrong. That happened to me there, too. Weird. He tried to do a taunt. Didn't really work out. That was a weird cue of the audio happening. Now he's getting chased. That's great. Alright. This is a weird encounter at the moment. You son of a bitch. Where's my blue sentinel? This is your job. How many heals do you have, by the way? Hi. I know he's there. I know he's behind me. You're not luring me into more of them, by the way. Oh, red guy's showing up. Alright. There's a lot of neutral parties in this fight right now. Authentic Dark Souls experience. I'm just gonna go up here now. Hey, Blue Sentinel, where you at? Uh-oh. He's using a bow. He was right behind me. I didn't realize that. Oh. Did you not take full damage? This is the anti-progress, but it's the PvP experience. I cannot tell what counts as a hit sometimes in this. Oh, son of a bitch. That's bad. Alright. Jesus Christ. So, backfired a bit. I'm amused by that, though. Caught it on film. Rematch! Oh. That's cute. Ow. Well, there's some free damage. Well, not that free damage. If I took the damage there, that was amusing damage. Hey, buddy. Murder? I always backstab when I don't mean to against these guys, and don't backstab when I do mean to against these guys. It's like, is that behind them? No. All right. Got my souls, got my ember. Was there an item up here? No? Okay. Tower's now clear, so there's no longer a guy shooting me constantly, so I can explore this whole area below us that has all the Viking-looking dudes around. Hello. So I don't have to deal with the previous problem. Hey, guys. So we know that you have a follow-up attack now. We have to worry about that. Oh, range on that, huh? Woohoo! Alright. Where's your wolf? There he is. I want your wolf to attack first, not the other way around. Ow. Roll! Get away! Be aware of where he is. I just don't want a distraction midway fight through the fight. Hello. Oh, I kicked on accident. Whoops. Woohoo! Oh! Timed that one wrong, huh? Oh! Oh! Okay. My bad. Oh! Woohoo! He angry. He dead. He dangry? We can't mix these words. Shame on me. Alright. So no more constant archer attacks. I can look around for items. We snuck through that side usually. I usually run through the right side when I'm walking in. Because there's actually no one to attack you. The one patrolling guy doesn't notice you. Hey. See, you're guarding something. I'd like to have that thing, if you don't mind. Please. Oop. There we go. Just have to over-rotate a little bit because they're kind of pivoting to the side. He's not dead. Woohoo! Roll! Hi. Aha! Faster weapon wins. It's like I was the dog this time. Ha 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 ha. On we go. Heavy gem. That's basic. I've got a lot of those, actually. That's like my third heavy gem of this DLC, I want to say. When I cleared the guy at the bottom of this tower, he dropped a heavy gem when I was coming back. Anything around? Oh, hello. See, that's what I want the dog to do. Oh. Gotcha. Sorry. Sorry about that. Had to be done, though. Couldn't be avoided. Hi. Whoop! Blocked just in time. Woohoo! There's a lot of panic blocks where I get the shield bashed the last second so it doesn't hurt me, but it still obliterates my character. That was weird. My controller seemed to shake as if I got hit by that attack, which threw me off. Oop! My stamina! I need that! Ow! The hell of a backswing he's got there. You're like, oh, I'm totally out of... I'm not in front of him at all. Boom! Still got hit. Keep forgetting I have this ring on for bonus dex. I'm sure there's other rings that are better in this game. I mean, among other things, there's one that gives you bonus dex that's just worth more dex. But this character has not done a complete playthrough, nor has it done a particularly thorough one, because I was trying to get him ready for this DLC. So, to recap, if somebody didn't notice, I have Life Ring, Chlorinthy, Estus, and Karthus. I'm sure there's better, but I don't have a lot of rings in general. That's the grand total of all the rings in my inventory that aren't casting, because I put that stuff in the stash. Is there anything that's going to happen to me out here? Yes, there is! Hi, dog ambush. Did I just steal your bone? Next! Oh, they're behind me. They're both behind me. That was a successful circle. One of them was actually behind me without me seeing them go behind me. I saw one of them circle and then realized the other one was already gone. And the only thing that really gave him away is that you can hear him growling behind you. I'm like, oh, he's behind me. At this point, I'm pretty much just killing these guys for fun. I generally want to kill every enemy at least once. Like every spawn when I'm doing my playthroughs. Hello, dude. I kind of went around. Wait, no, I did kill you already, didn't I? Right, I killed you and then went up the hill. We're done with you. So that's this whole area? I hope I didn't miss anything. One of my fears is that because we're playing an ice level that I'm... Like, much like the ash level and other ice levels in the past. Funnily enough, this is a snow level. It's called Ashes of Ariandel. Go figure. Whenever there's that color scheme on the ground, I'm always worried about missing drops because they're the same color as the floor. And that's obviously a potential problem. Alright. So this is actually a relatively small and not very eventful zone with a few bad guys here, tower guy shooting at you, some interesting geometry to walk on. So really a lot of liveliness was added to the scenario by being attacked by, hello. Oh, there's another big wolf. Hi. Oh my god, he jumped behind me. Oh, so there's more than... Oh right, I didn't kill you last time. You're a reoccurring enemy. That's cool. But yeah, I think that particular location was made more interesting by having a PvP encounter actually happen in it. I like that they're doing this, by the way. Ow. when I was getting this character prepped, one of the things that came to mind for me as being like a really cool owl. Let's focus on this a little bit. Oh, is he down again? There we go. Bye. Tide Knight reward. What stood out to me when I was replaying is I got to Boreal Valley and I encountered the Sullivan beast that chases you. They recycle the beast in that one basement by putting two of them there and stuff, but the time he chases you across the bridge, and then the continuity of environment where he actually shows up again if you go under the bridge, like, that part was really cool. Especially the idea of a reoccurring enemy, which isn't very common. I'm trying to think of other instances of reoccurring enemies in Dark Souls where I don't mean it's like a repeated enemy, but it's literally the same individual unit reoccurring. And the main time that comes to mind is that in New Game Plus of Dark Souls 2, the Duke's Deer Freya attacks you in the level before the boss fight, and whatever damage you do to it actually persists in the boss fight, and it's a really cool little surprise. Aha! Don't kill me. Okay, that was actually a really big fall, wasn't it? I think there's a scripted not to take damage then. Oh, here we go. We're here now. This is the series of ridges I need to fall down to get to that one item we saw before. Let's just be careful, and we're good. Maybe check for secrets a bit. Don't have to worry about durability at all, because right after this is going to be my revive. I'll just go ahead and rest at the bonfire. Maybe check out what those ashes do. Large soul. Is that it? Ah. I mean, I like souls, but okay. Alright, well, that's how that environment loops back together. Now we know. But yeah, I like the way that they did that with the Duke's Deer Freya, but unfortunately Freya is not the most interesting boss fight. And it's usually not a very common mechanic, but now this is like a neat little thing where they're using a character and having them be continually chasing you around. I guess the main other example of that would be actually the dragons. There are dragons ever since Demon Souls, where they'll show up at one location, and then the same dragon will show up at other locations if you didn't kill it, which is very likely. You're very unlikely to actually kill any of those dragons along the way.